Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
The Lord spoke with me about a meeting that he's sending me to, a healing service. Looks like it's at night. So it is at night, and this is now the French Guiana. It is at night. So again, within the same zone again. We're talking about the Caribbean nations and down in South America, Latin America. And now, this time around, this is the French Guiana, and it's night. So it seems like the healing service there is going to be at night. It is night, and I see a very major visitation that will take place there. A very, very massive visitation, because I see the light, and then I see the person of the Holy Spirit come all the way from heaven and visit the meeting in a way I cannot describe here on the phone, and also I'm not allowed to say so. But the person of the Holy Spirit visits the meeting, and so there is a tremendous visitation that takes place there. So at the same time, you can see, as the Lord speaks about the visitation of this hour, he's also now speaking about judgment. So the judgment and the revival are coming at the same time. And this visitation is the second one to French Guiana. So really, 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 this is the hour at which they have to grasp and grab the gains of this revival, that now they're up to their game and stop sin in the church and prepare nationally for the coming of the Messiah, the way Kenya is doing at this hour. And when many nations, I see the Lord is showing me rain, that there is rain coming also, there is rain coming. So the Lord is bringing rain, the rain of the Holy Spirit, unto the nations. And we know very well that Kenya, ever since that rain befell in this land, the landscape, the spiritual landscape, the landscape in the house of the Lord, the landscape of the church, has never, ever been the same again. It has been a tremendous visitation that has continued to move from glory to glory to glory, and is going higher and higher every time, including the meeting coming up in Nakuru. And so the same rain has fallen unto Nigeria, and that means if the Lord will find servants as he has found there, and if they will now up their game to grasp and grab the gains of this visitation, there is going to be a similar revival in Nigeria, even greater. And the same rain he has spoken to South Africa, that is going to take place in a place where when the man of God stands, he will be able to see some buildings, and then there is this tall building. It's as if you are moving towards a valley, and then there is a tall building there, and the top of the building like the stairs, steps like that, and beyond a little bit on the other side of the hill, there is a hill that slopes. There's a slope on the other side, a hill that runs on the other side at the end of the valley. There's now a hill with residential quarters on that side. South Africa also will see this rain, the rain of the visitation of this hour, the rain, the latter rain of the Holy Spirit. And so the Lord is willing. This is a sign that the Lord is willing to revive all nations. It was never ever meant for Kenya alone. The revival in Kenya, I know, is too high right now. The levels are absolutely historic. The biggest revival in the history of the Bible, the history of the church. However, this revival and the cloud of God that is visiting Kenya now is actually global. It is global, because when I was in Angola, also the Lord put a pillar of cloud on his servant as he was moving around like this, following him in front of the pastors at the pastors' conference. So the Lord is saying that revival is not exclusive to Kenya, that all the nations have a right. Every nation has a right to partake of this revival, because the kingdom of God never meant for Kenya alone. It is for all the nations, except one thing, that if all the nations would adhere to the message of holiness and righteousness through the repentance and the turning away from sin, then they too will be positioned in the place where Kenya is and partake of this historic revival of the Bible, the revival of the cloud, the revival of the glory of the cloud of the Godhead. God the Father himself visiting the church, coming down into the meeting. The revival of the open heavens, the revival of the reign of the Holy Spirit. So this revival is essentially, I decree it here and announce it, that it is for all the nations. It was never meant for Kenya alone, and by the Lord promising rain in South Africa, promising rain in Nigeria, promising rain in rain, all the time, rain. That means the Lord is saying, the heavens are open to all the nations, except that he is looking for holy, worthy instruments, worthy vessels that can be able to anchor this revival whenever the man of God comes to your land and makes his decree. There are some people that are supposed to anchor this revival like Kenya did, to run around and now turn around from sin and begin to install holy altars of the Lord in the land. That is the message the Lord is speaking now to the nations, and he's saying that this is the hour for the visitation of the nations. So much sexual sin has been in the church, the gospel of prosperity, the pride of the false apostles, the pride of the false prophets, and all these things you see happening globally. The false prophets that are lying to the church, harvesting money, false apostles that are accumulating wealth for themselves. The Lord is saying the time for revival is now. And this is the hour at which the Lord is also passing a warning to the nations. Venezuela, a huge revival when the Lord sent me there. One of the biggest that is only closest to Kenya, not closer to Kenya than Venezuela was. But because of the abusiveness of pastors in Venezuela, they let go a powerful revival. One of the biggest, I thought it would beat Kenya by hundredfold, in Puerto Ordaz, in San Felix, in El Tigre, in Valencia, in many places, the revival lit up. I went across the entire nation. However, the same corrupt pastors, when they came on board, they stole it, and then they thought it would be used for corruption and money again. And then I spoke the judgment that you see consuming Venezuela until today, that you see humiliating Venezuela until today. So the Lord is also passing a warning at the same time as he brings this revival, that you cannot contempt this revival. Nobody can decide it and use it for personal gain, earthly gain. So this is the hour for the visitation of the Lord and both the judgment against sin. The sin of the love of money in the church, the sin of sexual sin in the church, the sin of lies in the church, the sin of the false apostles in the church, the sin of false prophets in the church, the sin of the nudity of women in the land, women just walking naked and sexual immorality rampant. The Lord is saying this is the moment to realize that Christ is the King who died and coming back. But this time as he comes back as the glorious King that the nations must now all prepare for the coming of the Messiah. May the Lord bless you. I have seen the Messiah coming. May the Lord bless you as you prepare for the glorious coming of the King. Shalom.